Hey everybody, I am back here with another Sense of Days Gone By, my weekly warm wax review. As always, if you don't want to watch the whole video, then please, you know, go to the description box for the video, underneath the video, and it'll have timestamps of each of the scents that I melt, and then the time that I talk about them, so it'll help you either pick and choose, or figure out if you want to watch the video, or not want to watch the video, or whatever you want to do. I've had kind of a busy wax week, in that I've been placing a lot of orders, and I'm kind of getting back into... You know, when I first got into wax and pretty much every vendor that opened, I felt like I needed to order. So I laid low for a while and it's kind of coming back now. And I think it's because of the fall. And I first got into wax in the fall. So I'm coming up on my 1 year anniversary of buying vendor wax. And I have these awesome memories of, you know, first buying wax. And I love the fall scents. And I think that's kind of why I've fallen off the wagon a little bit. So my wax cup runneth over a little bit now. So anyways, I'm probably going to have to figure out, you know, what I want to give away to family and things like that. But you'll be seeing a couple more hauls for me coming up here. Okay, so just getting into the review, let's talk about this one first. This first one is from A Life Deliberate Soap Company. And this one she calls Tortola, which is Pink Sands type. The wax itself, just so you guys know, was super, super cute. It was this cupcake. I think it was like green on the bottom and it had like this white topping. And then there was a turtle on the top with like... some like sprinkles and stars or something like that. It was really cute. So I cut it up into two pieces. I put one in the glade in the bedroom and then also one in the glade in the bathroom on a different day. And it had a high throw. And this one actually threw better than any of the Pink Sands tarts themselves I have ever gotten from Yankee Candle. Although it didn't smell exactly like the Pink Sands. It seemed to be a little bit more floral maybe than I recall Pink Sands smelling. But it was, you know, in that same family, it was kind of close. But definitely a good piece of wax, very, very cute, high throw, you know, very acceptable performance and everything like that. So I would absolutely, you know, get this again from A Life Deliberate Soap Company. I haven't bought any wax from her for a little bit of time. I do know that she put up like individual wax melts on her website. So if you're not like really a mystery box person, I don't know what is left, but I think that's how she's going to do it from now on out is like, maybe she'll still do mystery boxes, but if you want to go buy like individual pieces of wax, I believe you can do that now through her website. Okay, the next one here is BZ Tarts, and this one is in Madam President. So this one is a remelt for me. The first time I melted this, I got a low throw. So I remembered that going into this, and I said, okay, let's just give this one another go. I threw this one on again in the 24-watt hot plate. I put it on before I went to bed. I was probably awake for about an hour, you know, while it was starting to melt. I do not remember smelling that much of anything again. I would say maybe it was like a low to a medium throw. I could smell it if I kind of got closer to the warmer, but I don't know if it was that maybe I went to bed before it really blossomed, or maybe this one just has a low throw. I'm not sure. The scent itself is really good. It's jasmine, citrus, rose, freesia, musk, ozonic nose, vanilla, and with an amber base. So it's a really, really good scent. I think it's kind of masculine smelling, to be honest, which I like. I like masculine smelling scents, so that is what is in the scent. But, you know, once again, second time melting it, and I definitely got a below average performance from what I normally get from BZ. So if there's anyone out there that has melted this one, let me know if you got a good performance. Maybe I just shouldn't have fallen asleep as fast as I did that night, or I don't know what's going on. But yeah, I just didn't get much out of it. Oh, also, if anybody out there, has anybody out there got anything from BZ from the last restock? I was able to place an order, and I know he said the turnaround time was like maybe up to 14 business days, which is fine, but I think people have been saying they haven't seen him like log on to either his Facebook page or anything for ever since the day he restocked, and I think we're all a little worried that something may have happened to John. So if anybody out there has heard from John or has gotten a CNS, let me know. I'm not as much worried about the wax, I think, as we're just worried that maybe something came up for him, or, you know, that he's okay. Okay, the next one here is Candles from the Keeping Room, and it is Wood Violets and Sugar Maple. And this one here, I melted two of the tarts that I got in this bag. So I wanted to talk about it because I'm not expecting to finish this bag here anytime in the next, you know, like couple months. So that's what the tarts look like. This one is, it's wood violets, which Carol calls a more sophisticated type of violet than a regular violet. She says it's deeper, and then it also has sugar maple. So it's kind of an interesting blend of floral with like a bakery type scent. And in her scent description, she says it's more green spa floral type than it is bakery. It is an interesting blend. I think I would consider this more bakery. I think I get the maple on here a little bit stronger. And when I was melting it, I'm pretty sure that's what I got as well. It's interesting. It's very rare, I think, that you see like a floral scent mixed in with like a sugary scent. Interesting. Anyways, I'm not really in love with it. I don't think that this is one that I would necessarily seek out again. However, the throw I got from this one, the two times that I melted it, was a medium to a high throw. And I melted it twice in my Glade warmer in my bedroom. It's one of those ones that you can smell it, you know, but it's definitely not overpowering. You're not enveloped in the smell or anything like that. It might have done better if I had melted it in the 24-watt hot plate. But anyways, medium to high throw. Interesting scent. So you guys could take that for, you know, what that's worth. This next one here is from Daphne's Divine Scents and Aromas. And this was a chunky muffin in blue raspberry icy pink lemonade. Really nice scent. It was very, very, like, kind of summery, fresh. It was a little bit heavier on the candy than I expected. So when I smelled it on cold, I could definitely get like a stronger candy scent, which is not really my thing. But when it was melting, it definitely came across as more of like that blue, like blue icy, kind of a little bit of effervescence, you know, tartness of the lemonade kind of scent. So I definitely enjoyed that. The throw from this one was a medium throw when I put the entire cupcake in my 24-watt hot plate. It's one of those where like it was such an effervescent, fresh, fruity kind of scent that it kind of gave the room like a very nice ambiance, but it wasn't like very obvious that it was a fragrance. It kind of had that kind of presence, something like that. But if I did walk close to the warmer, I did like walk into this like arc of where I could definitely tell it was a fragrance, but I had to be maybe within 4 feet of the warmer in order to kind of get that fragrance from it. But in the rest of the room, it was more of an ambiance. So really nice scent. I think I would have preferred a little bit of a stronger throw from that, but I know Daphne's is not in, you know, she's not in a business anymore, so I don't have a chance of getting that one again anyway. Okay, the next one here from Daphne's Divine Scents and Aromas. This one is Eucalyptus, Spearmint, and Peppermint. I put this on in the bedroom in the Glade warmer, and it had like a low to a medium throw. I did fall asleep on this, obviously, and I don't remember smelling it much before I fell asleep. And then the next morning, I could only smell it if I left the room and like was walking around the house doing stuff, and then I came back in the bedroom, then I could smell it again. But while I was in the bedroom with it for any period of time, I really couldn't smell it. That was in the morning, you know, after it had been melting already for like 8 to 9 hours, but couldn't really smell it much before I went to bed anyway. So I'm gonna call this one a low to a medium throw. The scent itself though is really good. It's a really refreshing minty scent. I mean, obviously it's pretty much like, you know, eucalyptus, which is like very like, you know, relaxing and you know, that kind of scent, and then spearmint, obviously, and peppermint. So all those mints together in this blend makes it one of my favorite types of scents. Okay, the next one here is from Haley's Heavenly Scents, and this one was a 6-pack of scallops in leaves. And I melted this 2 times, so I got 2 melts out of this one so far. And this one I think this may be a dupe for the leaves by... Is there a leaf scent that somebody has? Shoot, is it Yankee? I don't know. I think this is a dupe. Her scent description calls this ground cinnamon, dried apple peel, allspice, clove bud, and Vermont maple syrup. Definitely is mostly an apple scent with a little bit of cinnamon. I melted this one 2 times in the bedroom, 1 scallop at a time. What did I put this in? I think I melted it once in the Glade warmer and once in the 24-watt hot plate. And it had a high throw each time. You know, each time I walked into my bedroom and I was hit with like in the face with that like apple, like that, you know, autumny apple kind of scent, you know, from the apple and then all the different spices in here. Definitely smells like autumn. Very nice scent. Not my favorite autumn scent, but definitely like a decent performing piece of wax. Okay, the next one here is also from Haley's Heavenly Scents. And this one was one of my favorites of the week. This one here is in Winter Garden. And the scent description for Winter Garden is... And it kind of surprised me because some of this stuff I did not smell in here. Sorry, there's a lot of crinkling going on. So in here is fresh lime and menthol, Douglas fir, lavender, eucalyptus, and pine. And there is something about this one I absolutely love. So I melted this one 2 times this week, 1 scallop at a time, once in the 24-watt hot plate, once in the Glade warmer in the bathroom. And it was like a high throw each time, maybe even bordering a good throw, but it was definitely a throw that was decent and acceptable, more than acceptable. Now, I thought it was like a fresh, clean scent. It was like slightly reminiscent of laundry, and it smelled minty, even though I didn't smell any mint, if that makes any sense. It also smelled green to me, and then I just said, love it. There's something about this one that is just perfect. It's a perfect, like, when you just like want a nice clean scent that's not overwhelmingly loungy or overwhelmingly minty, but it's kind of like in that same family of that stuff, I would get this one. So I don't know if it's the menthol in here. I've never had a tart with menthol. Maybe that's what's making this one good. I do love pine blends. So like the fir and the pine is in here. I love that. I love eucalyptus. I can tell you that I do not smell lime and I don't necessarily smell lavender either. Maybe I do smell lavender. Either way, you guys, this one is amazing. And this one alone would make me go back for more, probably before the end of winter, because I can see myself going through the rest of those four scallops pretty fast because it's really good. Okay, the next one here is an empty, and this one is from Rainbow Melts. This one is a remelt for me in blueberry butter brickle bread, and this is blueberry burst butter brickle and then Amish bread, so it's not a zucchini bread scent. This one is for the most part just pretty strong on the blueberry, and I really love Rainbow Melts blueberry. To me, it's just, it's kind of like, it's not too thick of a blueberry. It's just really good. It's just like a nice bakery blueberry, I think. So these were two Bundt cakes. I put one in the 24-watt hot plate in the kitchen and then one in the Glade warmer in my entryway. And it had a good throw both times. This one has consistently been strong for me. I've probably melted this now, I don't know, 3 or 4 times. This is one of my all-time favorite blueberry scents. And it is such a good performer. I am coming up on the custom order list for Rainbow Melts here soon. And I think I'm going to probably see if I can get like a bakery bag of or a brittle or something in this scent because it's so, so good. Oh my goodness, that blueberry butter brickle bread is awesome. Okay, the next one here is one that I got in a gift in like a little, in like a random act of kindness. I guess it's not random, but there was somebody out there in the wax world that somebody had shopped for her at the Rose Girls store. And then she sent me some of the things that she got, you know, from the Rose Girls store. Holla! Thank you so much. So I did not buy this one myself. And this one was like a skinny, round, chunky pie, but like small, obviously, because it fit into this bag, in watermelon slush lemonade. I don't know whether I want to consider this Rose Girls because, from my understanding, I think this was probably poured by Kathy, you know, who is the original founder of Rose Girls. And you guys know that Jenny runs Rose Girls now, her daughter. But Kathy will still like occasionally pour things for the store. And then she also like pours pies for eBay. So I'm going to call this like Rose Girls and then in parentheses like Kathy's wax product, because obviously, even though Kathy is not formally, you know, running Rose Girls anymore, obviously like her techniques and the scents and everything she's using is Rose Girls. Anyways, okay, talked about that enough. This one was really, really good. So I cut this pie into 2 slices. One I put in my kitchen in the 24-watt. The other one I put in the Glade in my entryway, and it was so effervescent, so fizzy, so nice and strong, and that tart lemon, but like not overly tart where it's like going to make you pucker or anything. It was really good, and it was a good throw both times I melted it. The time that I was melting it in the kitchen, I was coming down the stairs from my bedroom, and I could smell it from my stairs, and it was like mixing with what I had going in my entryway, and I could detect that fizzy effervescence. So this one did really, really good. Such a summery, bright scent. Absolutely delicious. I will say going into fall, I'm probably not going to seek out that type of scent like anymore, probably until the spring, but it was a good piece of wax, and I thoroughly enjoyed the scent when I was melting it. So that is one of my favorites of the week. The next one here is from Sniff My Tarts, and this is another one that is one of my favorites of the week. So I melted 2 of the chunks. I'm not expecting to finish this bag anytime in the next couple months. I wanted to talk about it. This is Vanilla Bean Noel, Sugar Cookie, and a Wildberry Mousse. And I love this scent. The scent itself on cold and hot of this is just absolutely fantastic. It is so sugary. I love Wildberry Mousse. You can get that in here on cold very strong. You can smell that Vanilla Bean Noel. You can get the sugar cookie. It's just really, really awesome. Now, when I melted this, I melted it 2 times in my 24-watt hot plate in the kitchen. And both times, it was like a medium throw. I really could only smell it when I was like getting close to the warmer. If I was working in like the half of my kitchen that the warmer is in, I could smell it. If I moved out, I really couldn't get it anymore. But the reason it's one of my favorites of the week is just because the scent itself is so, so good. And I will continue to kind of mess with the warmer maybe to see if I can get a better throw out of this one than I did. But this scent is so, so good. And I will say this though about Wildberry Mousse. I don't think I have ever had any blend with wild berry mousse that was very strong. I don't know why. I don't know why. Even from vendors that I always get, or I normally get like a really good or a good throw from, I throw in something with wild berry mousse and it's kind of like meh. I don't know why. It just seems like one of those scents that on cold, I can normally smell it pretty good, but on hot, it just like disappears for me. And I don't know if that's a wild berry mousse thing or if it's just a me being stupid thing, but yeah, that scent is just so good. I just have to be close to the warmer to smell it. Okay, the next one here is from Starlit Candles, and this one is in Salty Sea Air. And I do believe this is a scent shot that Yuri sent me for free along with my order. It was more than just like a sample. She wanted to thank me for doing a video on the haul I had done with her like a long, long time ago. So she sent me like, it might have been like 3 clamshells and 2 scent shots or something like that for free. So I thought that was really nice. And I think this was one of the ones that she sent me like that. So I put this one in the Glade Warmer in my bedroom. And it was a medium to a high throw when I melted it. It pretty much smells like salty sea air. If you guys have ever had like cactus and sea salt or whatever, it's kind of like that scent, but obviously a little bit stronger because it's just pure like of that salty scent. Yeah, there's something in salty sea air that I can't put my finger on that it reminds me of something else, but I don't really know what it is. I tend to prefer my salty sea air scents when they're mixed with something else. So if I ever got this again, I would probably maybe even try to cut it in half and blend it with something else. But yeah, medium to high throw on the Glade Warmer. It does smell very thick. It's because it's just kind of like that one pure scent. It's a very thick scent. So I would get that again, but I would probably look to blend it instead of like, you know, melting it on its own. Not that I got paid for that the first time. I'll always tell you guys if I melt something that I did not pay for myself. Okay, the next one here is from 10 Digit Creations, and this was a 4-pack in Lake House. I do not have a scent description because I think this one was getting discontinued when I got it. Now, I don't remember how old this wax was. I don't have my dot on here, but I'm pretty sure it's coming up on probably like 10 months old to a year old. So it's kind of getting up there. It had a low to a medium throw every single time I melted it. I melted it in the bedroom, in the bathroom, and all of my different warmers up there. Just really didn't get much out of it. And I've noticed my 10 Digit Creations as of late have not been throwing as well as I remember them throwing when I first got them. And I don't know if that has to do with the age of the wax. It's just all of my TDC right now is just getting up there in age. So I don't know if that has anything to do with it. I will tell you though that I did see one time on the 10 Digit Creations Facebook page or their group page, Amber had come on and she had said that like, you know, people were talking about the age of the wax and the throw, and I don't exactly remember what was said, but I think she said that, you know, it really shouldn't matter that much and that, or something like that. So, you know, from the wax creator herself, I definitely recall her saying that the age really shouldn't be as big of a deal as we make it out to be. But however, I will say that my TDC has definitely not been doing as well lately as it did before. Okay, the next one I want to talk about is the Bathing Garden, and this one is in Cheshire Cat. And this one was one of the cutest tarts I have ever seen. It was like yellow on top with sprinkles, and there was like this really cute wax flower in the corner. It was beautiful, beautiful tart. Throw, however, was not good. It was a low throw. I put this one in the 24-watt hot plate in my kitchen one time. Didn't really get much out of it unless I was like hovering really close to the warmer. I then melted 3 cubes in the Glade Warmer in my entryway, and the same thing. I really just didn't get anything. If I was really close to the warmer, I could detect like a very strong tart lemon curd type of scent, but that was really it. And this one had cured for a long, long time. It had cured for about 7 months, so it was definitely cured. This one is lemon meringue, vanilla, and raspberry icing. Yeah, it just, for some reason, I just didn't get anything out of it. It's such a pretty tart, and I do have, I think, one or two more clamshells in this scent. If I continue to get no throw from this clamshell, I will not get this one again, no matter how pretty the wax is or how great it smells on cold. Just because if I get, like, a no to a low throw on something, if I give it a couple chances, I really won't go back for any more. All right, this next one here from the Bathing Garden. This one is in Curiouser. This one also was from the Alice in Wonderland. This one was from the Alice in Wonderland restock, so it's been carrying for quite some time. This one is sage, lemon, bergamot, carnation, lily of the valley, cedarwood, patchouli, and amber. I put this one in the Glade in the bedroom one time, and then the Glade Warmer in the bathroom one time. Low to a medium throw. It's one of those where I could detect like there was a hint of it in the air, but you can't really tell it's like a fragrance. But you can tell like there's something going on. It's kind of like that kind of throw. It's kind of a, I wrote down that I thought it was a refreshing green scent. And I really do love the scent. It's very complex. It's very deep. But the low to a medium throw. Now, this is one that I, if I saw it come up again, I would get it. Because I do not think I have a second clamshell in this. I would get it again to try it again. Because the scent itself is so good. So I would give that one more try. Okay, the next one I want to talk about is an older piece of wax that I have. And I'm trying to see if I can maybe get the camera up a little bit. This one is from The Spotted Hog. And The Spotted Hog is a company that I bought from when I first got into wax. Because I didn't even know who to buy from or where to buy from. And I think I Googled like wax tarts and The Spotted Hog came up. And I was looking at stuff and everything like that. And you can see I did get this one getting close to about a year ago. So I've been hanging on to it for a while. This is Perfect Pumpkin Pie. And this is in the little like pig shapes and everything like that. So there's a pig there. Now the scent description, she says it's pumpkin cream nutmeg with a buttery crust, and it is a really good pumpkin scent, and it's probably actually one of my favorite pumpkin scents that I've run across. It's really, really good. It is kind of like a perfect balance of like creamy, but you can get the spice, and then the bakery notes from the buttery crust. And this one is a good performer. So I melted two of these last night. I put one in the entryway. And you know, like sometimes when you throw something on and you kind of forget what you're melting and you're walking around, you're like, what is that? And that's kind of what I had yesterday. So, you know, it was a high throw because I wasn't thinking about wax and I was walking around and it caught my attention because it was strong enough that I was like, what is that? And I do really like the scent. And I put one in my 24 watt in the kitchen, and it also was a high throw, maybe even bordering on a good throw. It filled up the entirety of the kitchen, my living room, like big room area. And it was very present, and it was a really delicious scent, and my husband really liked it too. And I really like it, especially for the age of the wax, getting close to a year old. I'm really happy that the scent throw is still pretty decent. And I'm looking forward to probably finishing up this bag, probably before Halloween. I will probably have melted through all of that one there, because I don't want that one to go much past the year old mark. But a good piece of wax. Okay, the next one I want to talk about here is 30 Street Wax, and this one is in... So 30 Street Wax, and this one here is in Kingdom of Florin. And if you look at the scent description there, you can see that it's got peach, watermelon, neroli, jasmine, pear, gooseberry, and raspberry, also with the scent of laundry. But the laundry scent in here is definitely the strongest note. I put this one on in the 24 watt hot plate in the bedroom, and I pretty much got the laundry scent out of it. But it was a pretty laundry scent, so I do like this one. I would get it again. It is really nice and kind of like just a nice clean scent. So that one for sure is definitely good if you like laundry. So I would recommend that one. Let's see here. The next one here from 30 Street Crafts is in Kokomo Keys. And you can see this one. I don't remember if I got this one as a sample. So this was Oops Wax. You know, like maybe it's underweight. The chunk looked fine to me. So this one is Key Lime Pie with almond, lemon lime pound cake, and vanilla wafers. This one I put on my 24 watt hot plate in my kitchen, and I got about a medium throw. It wasn't as strong as my 30 Street Wax normally is. I was making dinner at the time, so it's possible that the dinner smells were kind of overpowering this. However, after dinner, I left this one on, and it still never blossomed to like a stronger throw. So, it, you know, I would melt it again though. It was a good scent. It was a nice, creamy, sweet key lime scent, so it definitely did not come across as like very tart. It was more creamy and sweet. And it is a really, really nice scent. So, So anyways, definitely a good scent. The throw was a medium. However, that could have been because I was making dinner at the time. So I would give this one another try. Okay, the next one here from 30 Street Crafts. This one is in Postcards from Japan. This is one of my absolute favorites from 30 Street Crafts. I don't think this one gets enough love. And it's got mandarin, mango, peach, lime, jasmine, orange flower, and then also strawberry. I think the standouts in here are the mandarin and the mango, peach, and the strawberry. It's a very, very strong, amazing fruit scent. It's really good. This is the second time I've melted it. Oh my God, that is just so, so good. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful fruit scent. And there's not a single one of the fruits that overly dominates the blend. It's kind of like a good blend of all of those, the peach, the mango, the orange, and the strawberry. I put this one on in my 24 watt hot plate in the bedroom, and it just did so well. It's a good throw. It's second time I've melted it. The first time was a good throw. Amazing scent. Good throw. One of my favorites of the week. I absolutely just love that one. I would love for it to come back. but I don't think it ever has got enough votes to come back. It's just, but it's so good. Okay, the next one here from Two Timing Tart is actually this one here in a blueberry lime cheesecake. And this one here, it's kind of a thicker blueberry scent, and I feel like it has an additional thickness. I know it seems strange to describe a scent as thick. Okay, I can smell this. I just opened up the cup over here as I'm talking, and I can smell it already. But the cheesecake scent in there also kind of makes it thick, if that makes any sense. You can get a little bit of the lime, but it's mostly blueberry, then cheesecake, and then maybe a tiny hint of lime at the end. But I really do love the scent. So I put this one on in the Glade Warmer in the entryway. High throw. I could easily smell it. I was having another one of those days where I threw on wax and I'm walking around and I forget what I'm melting. And I was walking up and down the stairs and around, and I was like, what am I melting? Like, that smells really good. So it was a high throw. It caught my attention when I was not thinking about it. I would absolutely get this one again. And I do think I've got a couple more of those scent shots hanging up. That's a good piece of wax. The next one here from Two Timing Tart was Eloquence. And I just got a bag of Brito on this one, which I'm really happy about. This is a beautiful scent again. It's cashmere, musk, divine peach, and honeyed amber. It's just gorgeous. Very sophisticated, very sexy, just really, really nice. Oh, just so, so good. So this is a remelt for me. What did I melt this one in? What did I melt this one in? I melted it in my bedroom 2 times. I don't remember which warmer I put it in, but I could smell it easily when I walked into the bedroom. So I would classify this one as a high throw when I melted it this time. The first time I melted it, I thought it was more of a medium. So medium throw one time, a high throw the second time, but it's kind of in that kind of area. And it's just a gorgeous scent if you like musk. Oh, and along with that honeyed amber scent. And one thing I like about this is honeyed amber or amber scents to me tend to smell a little bit more on the masculine side, which I love. So yeah, amber and musk. That one are the standouts to me in that one. Okay, the next one here from Two Timing Tart is something that I melted in pink tea cakes. And you guys may think I'm crazy because you can look at the pour date on here and see that it was poured about, oh, what is that, like a week ago. Yeah, so anyways, I was talking to Becky on Facebook and she had mentioned that she had melted a couple of her things that were pretty fresh from pouring like within 2 weeks and that they had done pretty decently. And normally I let my stuff cure for like a really, really long time. But I was like, well, that's interesting because I never melt anything that close to the pour date. I almost always wait, you know, 1 or 2 months. So I said, let me just toss on 2 scallops and just see what happens because I've never done this before. So the scent description is pink sugar along with her tea cakes, which is tea, golden yellow cakes, and an orange marmalade scent. The scent itself, you guys, is awesome. The tea cake scent is actually pretty strong in there compared to the pink sugar. And you can get like the scent of the tea, which is complex, and you can get like the cake scent, which is very bakery and very sweet. One of my favorite scents from her. It's just really, really good. So anyways, I put it in the 24-watt hot plate. I let it melt, and it was about a medium throw. So when I was like melting it like on a weekday night, so I turned it off, and then the next day I turned it back on again, which I very rarely do because I wanted to see how it would do a little bit. And it felt like it actually did better the second time I turned it back on. It was more of like maybe a medium high to a high throw. It actually did fill up the entire kitchen area. And I could get that tea scent very strongly and also like the cake scent very strongly mixed in with the pink sugar. It's a kind of a more complex, unexpected blend, I think, than you normally get from pink sugar blends. But I really love this the scent. And if I got like a medium high to a high throw within like 1 week of it being poured, I'm going to let it cure a little bit longer. But I think it may, you know, it's probably going to do better the longer I let it cure. So anyways, it was an interesting experiment for it, but I'm gonna just let the rest of my stuff cure because that's what I tend to like to do. Okay, the next one here from Two Timing Tart is one of my favorites of the week, and this one is in strawberry flower sandalwood. When I got this, I absolutely loved it when I smelled it on cold, and I was hoping on hot it would be just as awesome, and it was. So this is like a bittersweet tart strawberry floral over poured with chunks of sandalwood, and I love it. It is a sweet, pretty sandalwood. The sandalwood is definitely the star, but you can get the strawberry that comes out with it as well, but it's more of like a sweet strawberry. So it's just like a really sweet sandalwood scent. I don't know. And I love sandalwood. I just really love this one. So I put this one on when I came home from work on a Friday, this last Friday. And I kept it on all the way through Saturday morning when I woke up from going to sleep. So it was probably on for, let's see, if I got home at 4, it was probably on for about like 16 to 17 hours. And the throw from this one was a good. I mean, when I first put it on, it was a good. It was filling up my entire bedroom. It was very easy to smell. And the next morning after like 16 hours of melting, I could still smell it at about a medium throw. So long throw, good throw, absolutely great scent. And I hope Becky makes more of this because I love it so much. And it's kind of an interesting scent. I would never think to mix strawberry with sandalwood, but it's so, so good. I love it. I love it. I do know that Becky hates strawberry. So actually, if you guys notice on Two Timing Tart, there's not a whole lot of blends that have strawberry in it. So that's probably not one of her favorite things to pour. But if that one ever came back, I would hoard the shit out of that stuff. Okay, the next one here is from Vintage Chic Scents. And this one is in... I feel like I missed one. Oh, I did miss one. I missed this one by Super Tarte. So let me go back to Super Tarte. Out of order here. I've got some of the stuff over here that's not an empty. I did want to talk about this one because I'm not going to be able to finish this one for a long time. But this one was a custom super petal that I got from Super Tarte in Zucchini Strawberry White Cake. And I love her strawberry white cake. And, you know, I love anything zucchini bread. So I thought I would just mix it together. That's a chunk that I had chunked up. I've probably melted this now about 4 times. Now, I will say, though, that this is my own blend. And I like it, but I don't love it because it's kind of like a dry zucchini bread. And I've come across that a couple times, zucchini breads that to me just smell dry. Yeah, and I thought that the strawberry white cake in here would be like cakey enough and creamy enough to kind of overpower the zucchini or mix well. But what I really should have done is I really should have mixed like zucchini and strawberry white cake and maybe a marshmallow or something else that was like really creamy. It needs something creamy in here, I think, to really complete it. However, the wax itself is good. The throw I've gotten from this, the 3 times I've melted it so far, has been a good throw. So definitely nothing wrong with the wax. It's just my own blend. If I could go back and do it all over again, I would probably choose something slightly different. But yeah, I mean, it still smells good. Don't get me wrong. It still smells good. It's just not one of my all-time favorite zucchini bread blends. But the wax itself is a good piece of wax. Okay, going back here to Vintage Chic Scents. Sorry about that little segue. This one here is in Little Briar Rose. And I absolutely love this one. One of my favorites of the week. Now, I couldn't remember the scent description when I melted it, but as soon as I started melting it, I was like, cotton candy and apple, because that was what I could absolutely smell, and it is. So this one is actually green apple, pomegranate, and cotton candy frosting. I did not necessarily pick out pomegranate, but the apple and the cotton candy came through loud and clear. It had a high to a good throw. I melted 1 tart in the Glade in the entryway, did pretty good, and I melted 2 in the 24-watt hot plate, did pretty good. Definitely a good piece of wax, good scent. High to a good throw, no complaints at all. The next one here from Vintage Chic Scents. This one is a 3-pack in the Spindle Curse. And I was a little surprised when I read the scent description this morning, because some of the stuff in there I don't think I really picked up. So I just thought it was a really sweet bakery scent, a kind of a nondescript, really good bakery scent. That's kind of all I had. Now what is in here is Cinnamon Glaze, Snickerdoodle Donut, and Jackie O. And that surprised me because I don't recall smelling any kind of like cinnamon, doughy kind of scent. So I'm like ripping into the bag here. I want to really smell this. I can smell it on cold. I don't know why on hot I wasn't picking it up, but I didn't pick it up on that when I was hot. So I melted 2 in the 24-watt hot plate in the kitchen and 1 tart in the Glade warmer in the entryway. And it had a high throw each time. So it was definitely a decent, you know, decent throw. You know, like I said, for some reason, the cinnamon and the donut scent was not as strong on hot as it was on cold. So it's not one of those ones that I would necessarily seek out again. I didn't love the scent, but it was a good piece of wax. Okay, the next one here from Vintage Chic Scents. This one is in Walk of Fame. It's kind of an older clamshell. No, it's not that old. Poured back in April. And this one is Strawberries and Cream. I picked up on the strawberries right away, and it was so kind of like, for some reason, I thought there may have been pink sugar in here. But it's just straight up strawberries and cream. And actually, now that I smell it, yeah, for the most part, yeah, it's strawberries. I don't know why I thought there was pink sugar in here at first. Maybe because the wax was pink and I was just being an idiot. Anyways, this one had a high to a good throw when I melted it. So I melted it once in the Glade warmer in my bathroom. I don't know how this one ended up upstairs on my bedroom wax, but I was like, this isn't really as much of a bedroom scent as something I'd want to melt downstairs. So I took the other 3 cubes downstairs and put it in the 24-watt hot plate in the kitchen. And it did, like, it had a good throw in the kitchen. So anyways, I really love it. Really nice, sweet strawberry scent. Good performer, good piece of wax. I will say this too with Vintage Chic Scents. I know I've seen this with clamshells from the Bathing Garden. So this one, you know, was poured back in April. But you can see here, if I push on it, it's kind of getting like... like a little mushy. Not, it's not super mushy yet. And like, for some reason, like you see that outside there is pretty stiff, fairly stiff, but I push here, like it just goes right in. So I don't know. And I think clamshells just do that. It's just one of the things about clamshells. So I'm going to go through the rest of my clamshells from Vintage Chic Scents and probably pull out the older ones and just start to melt them, because it's just a clamshell thing. It's just kind of what they do, I've noticed. Okay, now the last one here is from Yankee Candle. And this one is in Beechwood. And this one was in the jar wax melt. So this is not the regular round tart. It was the jar melt, which are the ones that were supposed to like push right out after you melt it. Now this one is Vetiver, Salt, Air, and Driftwood. And this one is a remelt for me. The first time I melted it, it really didn't do that well. And I was really disappointed. So I threw this one in again. I didn't really have that high expectations of it. However, it actually did pretty decently. It was like maybe a medium high throw to a high throw when I put it in my Glade warmer in my bathroom. So it was okay. And it's a beautiful woodsy scent, very fresh. So I really do love the scent. As far as the jar wax melts, I've just found historically, at least to me, they tend to have lower throw, I think, than the actual regular round kind of scallopy looking melt. So I hope I have some of this in the regular melt, because it's such a good scent. But these jar ones, I mean, they're discontinued anyway, I'm pretty sure. And I would not necessarily seek that one out again in the jar wax form. Okay, you guys, so that is it. So that is the whole sense of days gone by. I am actually working pretty hard on trying to get through some of my like bakery bags and some of my bigger ticket items. And if I think I'm going to finish a bakery bag within the next month or so, I tend to not talk about it in here. So that's why I don't have as much stuff, but I am trying to get through some of the other stuff. But I hope you guys enjoyed watching this, and I'll catch you on the next video. Bye.